See this right here? This is the Angtube streaming webcam. And before we even get into the review, I'm going to show you guys what to expect from this webcam.
Come on, let's go.
Let's go. Don't talk about it.
Now you guys have seen what to expect from this webcam and my pro gaming skills, we're ready to get into the specs of this device. This device costs $59.99, but it currently has a 30% discount, so you can get it for quite a bit cheaper. It records in 1080p and runs at 60fps. It has autofocus as well as an inbuilt mic, so you won't need to buy an external mic if you don't have one. It has a privacy cover, as well as the fact that it has three different lighting modes, and you can change it by tapping it at the top with your touch controls. Key reason why I recommend this webcam is the fact that it's plug and play. Well, as long as you read the instructions, and trust me, you need to read them, because I fast up myself, tried to do it without reading the instructions, and I actually thought I broke it. But funnily enough, I needed to download a recording software, and after you guys install AMCAP or OBS or whatever, everything will start working. And trust me guys, I really was relieved. I actually thought I broke it. In well lit areas, the webcam is amazing. It is incredibly clear, incredibly sharp, and also the autofocus really helps with getting a nice clean finish. The one thing I would say is make sure you don't go too close to the webcam, because it kind of struggles with the focus and the quality kind of goes a bit downhill. I must say the light on the webcam really does help with this, because it allows your image to be just that little bit clearer, especially in those low light settings where you do need some additional light so people can actually see your face. However, I do feel like when you're in a well lit room, the webcam kind of removes facial hair. I don't know how to explain it, but usually I have a long, thick, really thick moustache and beard. However, when I use the webcam, it's practically invisible, and I'm not very happy about that. The majority of this webcam is made out of plastic. However, it really does feel really durable and made very well to a high quality. Also, the key features on this webcam, the adjustable light, the privacy filter, as long as the little stand that you use to support it on your TV or laptop or anything like that, are placed in really convenient locations, so it's easy to access, easy to use. Even the flipping cable is placed at the back, so it's easily hidden behind your monitor or TV. Let's say you want a nice clean setup, you can manage the cables in a way that this isn't visible at all. Now, let's go through some problems I've experienced with this device. The first problem is that it really does struggle in low light areas.
Now, this is low lighting. The only light source is actually from the webcam ring light. And to be honest, it does light up quite a bit. Although there is some really dark areas back there, I feel like I'm gonna get jump scared. But overall, if you get a little bit closer, it gets the most key features in there. You can see my face, so that's the most important part. Although I do see a little bit dropping quality around there, I see a little bit of grainy parts, but overall it does look pretty good.
You definitely try and use this the majority of the time in lighter settings, so you don't have to deal with grainy backgrounds. Also, lights in the background that have exposures of 9000, for example. Also, while we're talking about the camera quality at nighttime, autofocus feature really does struggle at nighttime, always focusing in and out. Sometimes it focuses to the side of me and then it comes back to my face, and this can get quite annoying over long periods of time. Another negative of this device is the fact that there's no mute mic feature. Maybe I'm overreacting a little bit, but I really prefer when my webcam, or any microphone for that matter, has a mute feature. This is because maybe I'm talking and I don't want someone to hear something and they're able to hear it. It can just get quite annoying. So I'd actually have to trust in whatever website or application I'm using's mute button, instead of having one inbuilt on the system. And when I'm not using the mic, I actually unplug it due to the lack of this feature. Maybe because I'm worried of people listening to me while I snore or something like that. But me personally, that's what I do. The first application that I used to record on this webcam was AMCAP. This application was recommended in the instructions, and that's the first one that I used. And I was really shocked because I thought the video quality was terrible. Because in AMCAP, the video looks grainy in great quality lighting settings and terrible ones. The video quality looked really bad overall. Everything looked really grainy and you could see kind of the outline of my face. I just didn't like it. Even when I recorded and rewatched it, there was delays with my audio, delays with the video. Everything just looked really slow. I'll show you a clip now.
Hi guys, hope you can hear me. This is it in fantastic lighting. You can really see it focusing in on me. It's pretty sharp as well. I can say I really like the image quality. And little to no motion blur as well. Everything's staying stable. No fog or anything like that. And I really like it. It's really good.
And luckily, I did test out another recording software and everything was perfectly fine. I would just say steer away from the recommended recording software in the instructions and try something else because that was absolutely terrible. Now it's time for my final negative of this device, and that is the autofocus struggles sometimes. Sometimes it focuses in and out for like 3 seconds until it properly finds your face and stays there for another 5 minutes, and then it does the same cycle again. Of course, it's not really, really consistent, but it can get annoying at some points, especially when you're trying to record a video or say something serious and your autofocus is going in and out. It can get kind of inconvenient. Anyway, to conclude, this product is very affordable for the amount of quality you're actually getting from this device. Build quality is simple, clean, and also convenient because you're able to access all your things. The mic is all right, and if you're able to look past the lack of a mute feature, I would definitely recommend this mic in 2023. So guys, it's been your boy Mr. K. Hope you enjoyed. Please consider liking or subscribing or supporting the channel, and yeah.
This is the webcam when it has high levels of light. I'm using a different recording software now and it looks like the video is actually much clearer. Everything's a little bit more sharp. It still has the autofocusing feature, but the camera also looks a little bit wider and a little bit more spacious than before.